Have you had a C-section scar and now you're dealing with spotting or pain or even fertility issues? You might have something called an isthmocele. I'm going to explain exactly what that is, how you know if you have one or not, and whether it should be treated. I'm Dr. Lora Shahine, a double board certified OBGYN and reproductive endocrinologist helping people build families for over 20 years. If this is your first time finding my channel, welcome. Be sure and subscribe so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health. And if you're coming back and you're still learning more, thank you so much for being here. There's two other ways to learn and stay in touch. Number one, you can sign up for my weekly newsletter, link in the description below. You can get weekly updates of fertility in the news, some educational content from the week. And the second way to stay in touch with me is my Brave and Curious podcast. You can listen anywhere you listen to podcasts, and I have a playlist here on YouTube. It has so much information, weekly interviews with fertility experts, wellness experts, and sometimes a deep dive into discussions. I hope that these resources help you learn more about your reproductive health. Now, today we are talking all about isthmocele, which is another word for a C-section scar. It's something that's rarely discussed, but it can really impact your way of life and your future fertility. Not everyone that has a C-section will have an isthmocele or a defect in the C-section scar, but if you do, you've got to know all about it and know what your options are. Not all people with isthmoceles need to have it fixed or treated, but you again should know if this is you and if it will help you meet your family building goals. Today, we're gonna go over six main topics surrounding isthmocele. Topic number one, what is an isthmocele? I'm gonna explain it and help you understand more. Topic number two, how common is an isthmocele? You should know this. Topic number three, how is it diagnosed? Topic number four, what symptoms can you have with an isthmocele? Like, how can you start to get clues about whether you have one or not? Topic number five, how is an isthmocele treated? Once you get the diagnosis, understanding what options are available to you. And finally, topic number six, there's two main treatments, just observe or surgically repair. And I'll go through the pros and cons of each of these options. Now be sure and stick around to the end of the video where I go over very important questions to ask your doctor about your situation so you can truly advocate for your care. Now let's learn all about isthmocele. Topic number one, what is an isthmocele? An isthmocele is a defect in a C-section scar. Anyone that has a C-section technically has a scar on their uterus. You do an incision on the uterus in order to safely deliver the baby. You repair that incision in the uterus, you have a scar. But an isthmocele is a pouch or a defect or a weakness in that scar that can lead to symptoms and sometimes fertility issues. In that defect in the C-section scar, the isthmocele, it can trap blood, a little bit of mucus. It can cause inflammation. It can impact the transport of sperm when you're trying to conceive. It might impact embryo implantation and impact labor or uterine contractions when you're trying to deliver your next baby. Listen, not everybody with a C-section will have a C-section defect or isthmocele, and not every isthmocele is going to cause symptoms or difficulty getting pregnant or difficulty with pregnancy, but it is an important thing to talk about and learn about and know if it's impacting you. Topic number two, how common is an isthmocele? Well, the answer to this really depends on what research paper you're looking at, and it can vary widely. Anywhere from 44 to 84% of people with a C-section will end up with an isthmocele. That is a huge number, but most of the time they're asymptomatic and most of the time they do not impact fertility, but it can be quite common to see an isthmocele when you're doing imaging of a uterus after someone's had a C-section. When I mention facts and reference evidence in a lot of my YouTube videos, I really try to put the references in the description of the YouTube video. And a lot of the facts that are going to be in this particular video are from an excellent review article all about isthmocele that was published in the Journal of Fertility and Sterility in the summer of 2025. Topic number three, how is an isthmocele diagnosed? It's most often diagnosed with an ultrasound or a special type of ultrasound called a saline infusion sonogram, where we put a little catheter in the cervix and through the catheter we place sterile salt water or sterile saline in order to distend the uterine cavity to get really good imaging. You can sometimes use an MRI to diagnose an isthmocele, but what's really important about measuring the isthmocele or diagnosing it, sometimes you can see a little defect in the C-section scar, so that's technically an isthmocele. But what's important is the RMT, the residual myometrial thickness. That's the thickness of the remaining wall. Like how, we call it thickness, but like just how thin is that defect going to make the uterine wall? That can impact the type of symptoms that patients are having. It can impact the risk of fertility issues or even risk in pregnancy and later with uterine contractions. So measuring that residual myometrial thickness can be really important. I'm not usually ordering MRIs for my patients. I'm thinking about ultrasounds. And I know from a wonderful study in the Journal of Ultrasound and Obstetrics and Gynecology published in 2013 by the lead author Bill DeVat that when I'm thinking about which ultrasound type to order, a saline infusion sonogram is going to do a much better job of detecting not only whether someone has an isthmocele or not, but helping me measure that RMT, that residual myometrial thickness, because that thickness is going to help me decide what interventions to take and how to counsel my patients best. So that study, kind of bar graph here, that really shows saline infusion sonogram does a much better job of detecting and measuring the RMT compared to just a regular routine transvaginal ultrasound. Topic number four, what kind of symptoms can show up with an isthmocele? I think of five main symptoms. Number one, spotting. Number two, pelvic pain or pressure. Number three, difficulty with embryo transfers if you're doing IVF. Sometimes it can get pretty tricky to try to get the catheter past the isthmocele and kind of closer up to the top of the uterine cavity where we're trying to place the embryo. Symptom number three, fluid collection in the uterine cavity in the middle of the cycle or during fertility treatments. And topic number five, sometimes secondary infertility, meaning someone is having difficulty getting pregnant, there's a fertility issue, but they've already had a baby, they had a C-section, so they're having trouble getting pregnant again. You can sometimes think about, is an isthmocele one of the reasons that this is happening? Topic number five, how is an isthmocele treated? There's three options: observation, medical management, and surgical management. So observation is obvious. Just because someone has a little defect in their C-section scar, they're diagnosed with an isthmocele, they don't necessarily have to have it treated, especially if they're not having adverse symptoms. The second option is medical management for the isthmocele, but that's really focused on just treating one symptom, which is the spotting. So if someone's having spotting, they're not trying to conceive, sometimes that can be managed with an IUD, like a hormonal IUD, or even birth control pills or hormonal management to help stabilize the uterine lining, stabilize that area in the isthmocele that's collecting mucus and blood, and people's spotting symptoms can be resolved with hormonal treatment. The third option is surgical treatment of the isthmocele. Surgical treatment would be removing the defect, removing the isthmocele, and reclosing that C-section scar. And it could be done either with hysteroscopy, which is a camera going through the cervix into the uterine cavity and repairing the uterine cavity from within, or a laparoscopic approach where there is a little camera through the belly button, two other incisions, or sometimes three towards the bottom of the abdomen to allow for instruments to help, again, remove the defect and reclose that C-section scar. So again, a surgical approach would be from within the uterine cavity, a hysteroscopic approach, or from above, you know, through the belly button and other instruments through the abdomen, that's a laparoscopic approach. Topic number six, we're going to focus on two treatment options: observation versus surgical management, because most of my patients are trying to conceive, they're trying to get pregnant again. And if you're trying to conceive, you are not going to be taking a hormonal IUD or birth control pills. And again, that's only really focused on that one symptom of spotting. So for you're really trying to think about whether to treat or not to treat the isthmocele, that is what we're going to be focused on right now: surgery or observation. And there's pros and cons. So observation is doing no intervention. The pros of that, of course, is it's less intervention, no surgical risk. It's often very appropriate if someone's asymptomatic. Just because you see something on the ultrasound, you see a little bit of a defect and that C-section scar, it doesn't necessarily mean that you need to act on it or you absolutely have to repair it. But there are some cons of just observing and waiting. I can think of three. Number one, just observing doesn't treat symptoms that could be bothering a patient. Number two, it could delay fertility or delay conceiving if the isthmocele is one of the reasons people are having difficulty getting pregnant. And number three, a con is if this truly is a weakness in the uterine wall, that could be risky in later pregnancy, especially if someone would love to have a vaginal delivery after a C-section. The uterus is contracting later in pregnancy. If there's a real weakness in that wall, you're at risk of something called uterine rupture, which is an urgent situation that you need to deliver the baby very quickly in order to make sure mom and baby are safe. So then, should you do surgery? Well, there's pros and cons to doing surgery or surgical repair of an isthmocele. Pro number one, you can treat symptoms and people can start to feel better. And number two, there are some studies that show improved fertility and IVF outcomes if the isthmocele is repaired. A 2024 meta-analysis that was published in the Journal of Fertility and Sterility looked at outcomes of over 10,000 embryo transfers and looked at live birth rates in these IVF cycles in patients that had isthmoceles, whether they were treated or not treated. The results of the study showed a lower live birth rate in IVF cycles in patients with untreated isthmoceles with an adjusted odd ratio of 0.62. This means in patients that had an isthmocele that was not treated, they had a 30% lower odds of conceiving in that embryo transfer compared to the patients that were not diagnosed with isthmocele after accounting for other variables like age and BMI and embryo quality, etc. Another pro for surgery is you might have a stronger C-section scar and less risk of uterine rupture in labor if you are thinking about trying for a vaginal delivery after a C-section. But there are definitely some cons when it comes to surgery. I can think of three. Number one, surgery is invasive and it definitely takes time to recover and be able to try to conceive in the future. Number two, I know I shared that one study that seems that it can improve IVF outcomes, but every study is limited and we need more long-term studies before we can definitively recommend that someone should absolutely always get an isthmocele repaired. And number three, there's always a risk of recurrence. Sometimes the isthmocele, the defect, comes back even after you've tried to do a repair. I'm thinking about pros and cons of observation versus surgical repair. And it's not always clear cut, but one really piece of helpful information that came out of that review article from Fertility and Sterility from the summer of 2025. It was a great article because it was basically had some practitioners that were very much pro observation and not intervention, and others that were saying intervention can be very helpful. And one thing that kind of they concluded towards the end is an important factor to help you make this decision is that residual myometrial thickness, that RMT. If that RMT measurement is less than 3 millimeters, that can be the tipping point to say, I really think that it might be helpful to have this resolved. But if you have a patient that has an RMT that is 4 millimeters or greater, they're asymptomatic, they're, you know, kind of thinking about pros and cons of intervention, not super excited about having to go through, surgery or an intervention, you can really feel confident that there are some studies that say that it is okay to observe and not necessarily do an intervention. I hope that that is helpful. I'm really glad that you stuck around to the end of the video when I can tell you some very important questions that I want you to ask your doctor if you've been diagnosed with an isthmocele or you've had a C-section and you're now struggling with fertility and you're curious if this might be an issue that's impacting your fertility. These are some questions that I find very helpful. So question number one, do I have an isthmocele or not? Question number two, if you're diagnosed with an isthmocele, what is the RMT, the residual myometrial thickness? Question number three, do you recommend surgical repair for my personal situation? Or do you recommend observation? Go through the pros and cons and why the doctor is making the recommendation that they are. And finally, if we are going to do a surgical repair of the isthmocele, which approach do you recommend? Hysteroscopic, where you do a sort of an internal approach to repair it, or laparoscopy from above? I hope you found this information helpful. If you have had a C-section and you are now suffering from symptoms like pain or spotting or difficulty conceiving, I want you to think about the possibility of an isthmocele impacting these symptoms. Remember, not everyone with a C-section is going to be diagnosed with an isthmocele, and not everyone diagnosed with an isthmocele is going to need surgical repair. They do not always cause symptoms. Isthmoceles do not always cause fertility struggles, but it is a variable and something to think about if you're having symptoms, you're having difficulty conceiving, and you've had a C-section in the past. You deserve answers to your questions, and I hope this can help you advocate for your care. Like this video if you learned something. Be sure and follow this channel so you get my weekly videos all about reproductive health. And until next week, wishing you love, luck, and pineapples.